oral tradition. That is the topic outline. After that, we got something we call, that one is oral tradition, types or typologies. Typologies, it is the same as type of oral tradition. Here, we have typologies like formulae. We have another one, we have tales. We have religious rituals and religious ceremony. And then we have slogan. Slogan. We have slogan. Those are some of the, we have poetry and songs. Poetry and songs. So this one, number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And typology of oral tradition. Now what we will look next is number 3. Advantages is the same as disadvantages of oral Africa tradition. Here then we will look one by one. This one formulae, we will look at tales, we will look at rituals and religious ceremonies. We will look at slogans. People came up with many slogans. That forms part of sources of African history. We have after limitation and the advantages and disadvantages of African history or oral
social
anthropology. This one we will look at branches like cultural anthropology, and then we will look, this is type of analysis. Types of social anthropology, we have cultural anthropology and we have physical anthropology. Another thing, you know, here we will also look at limitations and advantages. Now number five, we are doing what you call topic outline, what we are expecting to know. We have archaeology as a source of African history. Archaeology is written this way, master the spelling. We will look at the definition of archaeology, definition. We will look at ENCO, you get? When you go to Maasai community, they believe that God Enkai dropped the first parent from sky. From sky when they had cows. You get? From the sky with cows. You get? That is some of the myths some of the communities have. Now I go forward, famous and known, who are responsible to conquer the enemy. You get?
Yes.
For example, you go to one Western Kenya, we have Luanda Magere.
Yes.
Luanda Magere. This man conquered the enemy of this region because they believe this man cannot die. The energy was in it, in where? In that shadow. But one day they realized where the energy was coming from. Because Luanda Magere, I want to give you a story of Luanda Magere, was a person from that area. One day, when he went to war, he was injured. Now the wife from the other community that was the enemy Kalenjin community, was applying some herbs to that Lwanda Magere. But Lwanda Magere told their wife, this, I cannot get healed when you apply this medicine to me, apply to my shadow. What happened? This wife ran and went to inform the enemies. You get about Lwanda Magere, the power is from the shade. Now what the enemy did? They spear the shade, the shadow, not the shade, the shadow. And they finished Lwanda Magere, who was about a superhero. This one means that people who are putting on suits, they are very dangerous. They have eaten from the government. That is the translation of Steve Cave. Some that is the mean Basba Chisuti. You get?
Yes.
Thank you, thank you. Now we have another one called Tess. Tess is classified into myths and legends. Into myths and legends. We have Tess. But Tess are classified into myths. Types of Tess. We can call them types of Tess. We have myths. Myths, they are the ones that show, explain to us the origin of something, the beginning of something. For example, among the Kikuyu, they believe the first parent to be Kikuyu and Mumbi had their first parent who bore nine daughters. You get?
Yes.
That is their thing. When you go to Western Kenya, okay?
Yeah, yes.
You can come up with your slogan. Read until you smell books. You get? That is a slogan, eh? Of somebody who came up with it. You can say from three points. You get? Coming up with the same slogan. Number three, we have rituals and religious ceremonies. Now here we have religious activity were conducted by these religious people in the community. But now when it comes to rituals, we have one example from Luo community. It is called Teroburu. Teroburu is a ritual where they do chasing away of evil spirits. When they believe that some community killed their own person, this time they select a cow. They slaughter this cow at the gate. So the blood remains at the gate. They took that cow, but the soldiers or warriors will go out with the clubs, spears to chase those evil spirits. But that meat was supposed to be eaten at the evening when the warriors or soldiers have come back. Those who went to work to chase away the evil spirit. In your region, they call it terror buru. You quote them because it's not of our own language. That is really rituals and religious ceremony. We have poetry. Number four, we have poetry and let me finish so that you can be informed and add more, okay? Poetry and songs. In traditional African society, or in if Africa is defined this way. Describe either the character of a people or an individual. Describe this one. Describes the character of people or an individual. Or an individual. So, for example, yes, we can. By who?
By
The former president of the United States of America, Barack Obama, of Nigeria, we have dialogue. Meaning that a leader of army, this means that that society had a political structure, had some form of political structure. Now we go for the next typology of oral tradition. No, experience of event of the occurrence of the event. Here you can give an example. For example, we have, when I give you a history of the First and Second World War, that one becomes an oral history because I was not there. It becomes an oral tradition, not history, because I was not there. When I give you the struggle to independence, for example, our country Kenya, and got high independence. In which year? 1963, I was not there. So, when I tell you that, what I am giving is oral tradition, not oral history, you get tradition. Now, we have number one, we start with formulae. These are praises. These are just praises. Oh, title that describes Nigeria, of Nigeria. Balon, here, this one, means a leader of army, This means, that society has a form of, and a form of. We got now finally, number six, we have linguistic. And linguistic in history is just the study of languages. You know, Kenya said, communities in Kenya migrated from one point to another. For example, Amer community, they were migrating from Mombasa all the way to where they are settling. That one we will study under linguistic, which is the study of languages. And here also, under linguistic, we will know more about advantages and disadvantages of linguistic as a source of African history. After that, now we continue. What is an oral tradition? We start one by one, as it is told by the informants who experienced the occurrence of the event. Here, oral history, it is different from oral tradition. Oral history is just the telling of the past by an informant, that someone who is informing you, who did it, but who had who experienced the occurrence of that particular event. For example, when I tell you 208, 207, 208 post-violence election, that one is an oral history. Example, you can give an example, e.g., 2007-2008 post-violence election is an example of oral history.
Lead us in our way homes and bless us even more. In our exams, we will be our provider, Jehovah Lord. Cover us with the blood of Jesus, dear Lord. And this for those little ones, I pray and believe.